Hello students, good morning, how are you? Nice. Yesterday we had learned about some natural phenomena in our introduction. Today we'll move one step further. Let us delve deeper into this mysterious some natural phenomena that we see around us. There are many natural phenomena, students. Why are they so interesting? Yes, you know, students, why they are so interesting? Because every time we know something about these natural phenomena, the next time still there is one new question. Oh, why is this happening? Why is that lightning? Still there is no many questions that are unsolved of this mysterious universe, and out of which we'll just start few things. Now let us see what is that. Okay, types of charges and their interactions. Okay, now yesterday we learned that these lightnings, the amber story that we had learned, okay, the charges, the when you were children, you used to play with the comb, you used to attract the pieces of paper, all these stories. There is something behind this that is known as charge. Now what is this charge? Okay, yes, let us understand. Okay, students, now let us consider an experiment. Let us consider an experiment. There is a material. Now each and every material we want to study is made up of little tiny pieces of particles. Yes, every big thing is made up of smaller things. Likewise, every big material is made up of very tiny particles, and those the tiniest particle will be called as an atom. Yes, students, what will be called as an atom? Okay, this is the atom. Now what is that atom? Let us see. If this is a material, this material is made up of very tiny particles that will be called as atoms. Now each of these atoms, it is filled up with the atoms compactly, and that hence it is a solid. Now each of this atom is made up of, further if you zoom into it, it is made up of number of electrons. Yes, it is made up of number of electrons, and made up of equal number of protons. They are made up of equal number of protons. Let us see. 1 2 3 4 5 6. 1 2 3 4 5, and let us add one more, 6. So it has 6 electrons and 6 protons. Okay, yes, this is actually an atom. It constitutes of electrons and protons in equal number. Yes, students, now what are these electrons and protons? Actually, these are very, very subatomic particles, and they are associated with certain, they are associated with mass. Yes, you know, students, what is mass? Each and every object that has, that can be seen, that has density, that has mass. Now further, these all particles, subatomic particles, have got one more property, and that intrinsic property, intrinsic means it is there already within it, that intrinsic property is called as charge. Just like mass is a property of an atom, of a particle, charge is one more property that is associated. What is that? Plus a proton is associated with a positive charge. Yes, students, what is proton? It is a particle, and it is associated with a positive charge. Yes, student, whenever we have got a proton, we call that it has got positive charge. Similarly, if we have electron, then we say that it has got negative charge. Yes, students, we will say that it has got negative charge. There you go, there is a proton and electron. Now students, positive and negative together become zero. If I say you have plus 5 and then I say you have minus 5, then what do you have? You have nothing with you. That means an atom which has protons and electrons in same number, plus 6, because we say that proton has got positive charge, positive means plus, and electrons have got negative charge, negative means minus. So if you do this, plus 6 minus 6, then you get 0. That means what? Atom has got no charge. It means atom has got no charge. If atom has got no charge at all, then we say that atom is chargeless. A material is chargeless, that is, it is neutral, it is stable. Okay, so it is stable or it is neutral. Okay, it is neutral, that is zero. But if I happen to add some more electrons upon this material, if I happen to add some more electrons upon this material, then what would be the situation? Yes, students, if there is a material and if I happen to add, there is, this has got equal number of positive and negative. But if I happen to add some more electrons in it, if I had two more electrons, then is it stable? No, it has got how many positive charges? 1, 2, 3 plus 3, and how many negative charges? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. It has got minus 5. So it has got 3 minus 5, that is minus 2. So it is not neutral, it is negatively charged. It is negatively charged. Yes, students? Yes. So how to get an object, how to make an object negatively charged? You have to add electrons upon it. Yes, students? Yes. Similarly, if I want to make a positive charge, what do I need to do? Yes, you may have to add protons. You may have to add protons. But students, here is one interesting thing. Yes, what is that? You cannot add protons, because protons are there inside the nucleus. You cannot add them. So you have to do what in order to make a thing positive charge? Let us see. If I want to make an object positively charged, basically, initially, the atom is neutral. Yes, students? The atom is, material is neutral. It has got plus, minus, equal, plus, minus, and let us take plus, minus. Is it zero? Yes. Is it plus, minus, zero? Yes. Now, if I want to make it positively charged, I cannot add protons. I cannot add protons. This process is not possible, because protons are there inside the nucleus. How to go inside the nucleus of atom? It is so small. So what do I need to do? Electrons. Electrons are free. Electrons, you know, you must have learned in chemistry, electrons are free to rotate. So they are free. They could be taken out. They could be taken out. I can remove the electron from this. Can remove the electron from this. And I can, if I happen to remove these electrons, now what is the total charge? Let us take positive 1, 2, 3, 4, plus 4. And what about the negative? Minus 1, minus 2, minus 2. So we have plus 2. That means it is positively charged. It is positively charged. Yes, students? So this is how an atom is positively or negatively charged, because of the protons and electrons. Now we will see how does this happen in practical situations. If students, if you have two balloons, okay? Did you understand this? Very good. Now let us move on to the practical type. Okay? Let us see what is protons and neutrons in real life situations. Okay? Yes. If you have two balloons, okay? Now, if you have these two balloons which are kept like this, let us take that you have kept two balloons besides. What will happen, students? The balloon, they will remain stable as it is. Yes, students? Yes. But now, if I give you a piece of cloth, and rub it over each of the balloons, and I still place them one besides another, then you know what will happen? Have you ever known? Yes, it is given in the textbook if you want to see. There are two balloons which are first kept besides each other. Nothing has happened. But after a while, they took a cotton cloth and rubbed on both the balloons. See what has happened? They have moved farther away. This process of moving away from each other is called as repulsion. Okay, this is before. But after rubbing, with a cloth, what is observed is that both the balloons are moving away from each other. They are moving away from each other. Why? Because this phenomena, this force is called as repulsive force. yes, the both the balloons move away from each other. This force is called as repulsive forces. Why does this happen? Both the balloons have been rubbed with the same cloth. Yes, that means what? There is change of number of electrons or protons upon it. By when you rub the balloon, students, listen very carefully. Whenever we rub the balloon, what happens is that the electrons from the cloth jump over to the balloon. Electrons from the cloth also jump upon this balloon. So what happens is that this becomes negatively charged, and this also becomes negatively charged. Yes, this also becomes negatively charged. Two negative charges, when they are brought closer to each other, they cannot be remaining steady. They have to move away from each other. Why? Because nature likes stability. No charges. Stability means what? Charges should be zero. Everything should be stable. Everything should be relaxed. But when two negative charges are brought towards each other, they are not zero. They are highly negative. But nature loves stability. So what happens is that they move away from each other. When they move away from each other, they tend to be more stable. Like that is why it is said that like charges repel. Yes, students, like charges repel. Why do like charges repel? Because they have to be stable. Yes, students, likewise, like charges repel. Yes, this is that situation. But students, instead of this balloon, I happen to take a refill. Okay, a refill. Okay, a pen's refill like this. You have a pen, and if you take a refill, and even you rub that, what happens is that when you rub a refill, it electrons from the refill jump over to the cloth. So what happens? It gets positively charged. Just few moments ago we learned that when electrons are added, it becomes negatively charged. When electrons are removed, it becomes positively charged. But when when you rub a comb on your head, what happens is that, okay, it gets charged up. Why? Because it is polythene, right? It is plastic. So electrons from here jump onto the plastic. Likewise, what happens? Electrons from this plastic jump upon to the cloth, and this it becomes positively charged. When it becomes positively charged, because electrons are not there. When it is becoming positively charged, what happens? It is positive. It is highly positively charged, and it is highly negatively charged. And when such balloon which is brought near the refill, what happens is that they tend to come closer. Why? Because it is positive, it is negative. It will be stable when they will be zero, because nature loves stability, nature loves zero state. So positive and negative come together and they become zero. That is why unlike charges attract. What can we say now? The unlike charges attract. Yes, students, unlike charges attract. We learned two things today, very important things to learn. What are these two things? Like charges repel and unlike charges attract. Very good, students. So these are the two things. Now, how to understand whether what makes a thing positive and what makes a thing negative? So let us see what is that. Okay, very good. Now, there is certain set of sequence. What is that? Let us see. Okay, yesterday we talked about amber. Okay, amber is a piece of resin. When amber is rubbed with silk, this is a silk. When both of these are rubbed, there is certain exchange of electrons. Okay, exchange of electrons. Okay, electrons from amber jump over because of rubbing to the silk. So what happens? There are lesser number of electrons, so this becomes positively charged. This becomes positively charged, and silk becomes negatively charged, because amber has tendency to lose the electrons.
whereas silk has tendency to gain electrons. Yes, students, this is what we learnt.
Amber has positively charged and silk is negatively charged because
positively charged and silk is negatively charged. Why is it so? Because
it has tendency to lose the electrons. When electrons are lost, it is positively charged. When electrons are gained, it is becoming negatively charged. Likewise, there are few number of materials that we are going to see. What are those? Glass and silk. What is that? Glass and silk. When you have a glass rod, okay, when you have a glass rod, can you see this? Yes, students, Malikarda, this is, okay,
when you rub glass rod with silk, what happens is that glass rod acquires positively charged. Okay, this is said, this is positive, this is negative. When glass rod is rubbed with silk, glass rod acquires positive charge. There are few more things, like for this is second one. What is the first one? Amber is rubbed with silk. Positive charge gets with amber and silk with negative. Glass rod is rubbed, then also glass rod only acquires positive because glass has tendency to lose the electrons. Similarly, we have wool. Wool rubbed upon ebonite. Yes, students, wool rubbed upon ebonite. Okay. Yes.
Wool is rubbed upon ebonite. Ebonite is a piece of material, okay, if rubbed upon wool, wool gets acquires positive charge, but ebonite gets negatively charged. Similarly, we have the situation that we had just taken few minutes ago. Refill with polythene. Okay.
Now this is refill. Refill with polythene. You know what is polythene? Plastic.
Yes, you have plastic, small plastic that stick to your skin wherever you want to. If you have your cover, notebook's cover, and if you remove just a piece of polythene from it, it sticks anywhere. Why does it stick? Because of charges. Even if you just stand near your television set, which is on, your hair stand up. Why is it? Because of charges. Okay, so it has got positive, refill has got positive charge. Few more are there. Wool and balloon. Just now we took the situation of balloon. Similarly, what happens is that the wool acquires positive charge. Okay, wool acquires positive charge and balloon acquires negative charge. Yes, students, is it interesting? Yes, you have to remember this. And the last one more is that hair and comb. Yes, very interesting, your favorite. Yes, hair and comb. When you rub your hair with comb, what happens? Your comb gets negatively charged. Your hair gets positively charged. Very good. So if you want to have your positive hair, what should you do? Should rub your hair, right? When you rub your hair becomes positive, you can also become positive. Let's have a fun. Okay, so students, your hair gets positively charged when you comb your hairs. Isn't it interesting? You should comb your hairs daily, right? Because your hair become positive, you also become positive. Good. Hairs and comb. Is it nice? Is it an interesting thing to remember? Yes, yes, we become positive when we comb your hairs. That's nice to hear. Okay, let's continue ahead. So, yes, students, this is for today. And we'll have one more thing. What is that? Charges are interacted by this phenomenon of rubbing. One more is this. What is that? That we learned today is charges are, okay, charges due to rubbing. Okay.
Charges due to rubbing. Okay.
Now, can we produce charges on any other material without rubbing? Is it possible to induce charges? Is it possible to make charges without rubbing? Okay, I can take electrons, I can add electrons, I make positive and negative. But even without taking electrons or without adding electrons, personally without rubbing, is it possible to make things positive or negative? Yes, students, it is possible. Let us see how. Okay, yes. You have to pause the video and complete that. Just before now we said, just pause the video and rub it. Okay, student, what is that new process is called? Charge due to, this is what we have finished. Now we'll go for charge due to induction.
Charge due to induction.
Yes, charge due to induction. Now what is meant by the word induction? What is the word induction? What is that induction? Student, induction means that if
I am a person here and I am very active, I am very interested, it means I am very excited. What happens is that a person sitting, standing besides me, he also get excited, isn't it? When I am very dull and I am very depressed, then people around me also, they will also feel depressed. But is it that I actually made them depressed? No. What happens is that when certain another body is brought near another body, there is some interaction that happens. That process is called as induction. Okay. Now, when does it happen? Let us take, this is the amber. When you rub the amber, what happens to the amber? Amber gets positively charged. Yes, we know that. Amber gets positively charged. You rub an amber with wool, it always gets positively charged. Yes, but if you keep a balloon near amber, so what happens, students? Balloon has got equal number of positive and negative. Why? Because balloon is a material, it has got all the properties of the material, it has same number of protons and electrons. But when amber is brought, which is very, very positive, what happens? Positive attracts negative because it has to become stable, right? It has to become zero state. So what happens is that these electrons are tried to pull near this surface because it is positive here. It is positive right here. Positive wants to attract negative. So all the electrons get aligned upon this surface. So what happens? The protons move behind an electrons. Positive repels the positive. So these protons move away. Protons move away and electrons move on this side. So what is the final diagram, students? Let's rub it and draw the new diagram. What happens is that all the negative charges go here and all the positive charges go here. This process is called as induction. And now see what happens. Positive is there here and negative is there here. Now what happens is that positive and negative attract each other, and after some time again what happens is that this balloon which is there standing here, now it is tried to be pulled due to this attractive force. It is tried to be pulled here. Okay, this balloon is pulled here due to the forces due to interaction. Okay. Charges due to induction. What is the answer here? Unlike charges attract each other. Yes, students, it's very interesting to learn, isn't it, students? Yes. So today we learned the balloon experiments, and today also we learned different types of bodies have got different charges. And one more last thing that we are going to finish, that all these charges, positive and negative, these are static. Static means what? Situated at one place only. They do not move at all. If you light the bulb in your house, what makes the bulb glow? There are electrons which keep on hitting the material and they burn. Due to hitting, they get heated up, and that makes the bulb glow because electrons are continuously moving. When electrons are moving, you call that the charge is moving. The charge is in motion. The charge is given current. It is current, but that is charges in motion. Here the charges are not in motion. So this is called as static. So this is study of all this is called as electrostatics. Study of all the static charges or charge at rest. What is electrostatics? Study of branch of physics that deals with charge at rest. Aren't these charges resting? Yes, they are resting. And what is current electricity? When charges are moving. Okay, students, did you understand? Okay, now relax. Take the pause. Listen to all what we said. Just try to summarize what we have learned today. Prepare the notes and complete the task which will be given to you. Isn't it? Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.